Hello, brothers and sisters. Welcome back. So I want to start with a prayer, and this will be my last prayer with all of you together. But even while you can't see me, I would always pray with you, pray for you. Okay. So this prayer is about, I want you guys to just remember the number one most important thing, that how much God love you. How much God love you. Because I know it's very easy to forget about this. And when we forget about how important, how much God loves us, then doubt start creep in. And that is not good, isn't it? So we need to not doubt God's love. So let's pray. As one body, one spirit, we come to your throne, Father. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for being the creative God who created all life and who inspires me to look at the world through your creative eyes. I look up to the sky and I see your beautiful creation. I look at the flowers and I see your tenderness and beauty. Lord, please help me notice this same beauty in each person that you created. And let me be especially mindful of your beautiful creation of each baby and child, which you allow us to join with you to bring into your creation through your miracles of conception and birth. Your creation of me and of every person is a miracle, as David wrote, "For you formed my inward parts. You covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your work, and that my soul knows very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and skillfully wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Your eyes saw my substance being yet unformed, and in your book they all were written, the days fashioned for me, when as yet there were none of them. How precious also are your thoughts to me, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I should count them, they would be more in number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with you." It can be hard for me to love some people. Please renew my mind that I may begin to view all others as part of your beautiful creation and your masterpiece. Please mold my heart so that I can seek out people who are overlooked and hurting and tend to them. Thank you, Lord, for your creation and for giving me the blessing of being your ambassador in this world. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Thank you so much for praying with me. So I am going to tell you what the Lord have revealed to me this morning. So I prayed again. I'm praying about the time. So basically I prayed, I asked God, I said, Lord, today is the last video I'm going to make. Please tell me exactly what message you want me to pass to the body of Christ and to the world. So I'm going to tell you which chapter the Lord guided me. He guided me to Micah chapter 1, 10 to 16, and 2 to 13. So this is the page he guided me. Okay. So I'm going to read the important one. So the first chapter is about the first 10 to 16. You can read from the actually Micah chapter 1 from the beginning. But I'm going to read it here because this is specifically the Lord guided me to here. The Lord guided me to Micah, first page before. This is not the first time. Many times he guided me to Micah. After I had my dream, the sword of the Lord and the lion Judah. This is the Micah is the one he confirmed me. Okay. He confirmed me with Micah. But today, specifically, he guided me to start from 1:10. And from 1:10, if you say the time, you know, it's concerning the time we're living now. What is the time we're living now? Right now is the enemy. The enemy is here. So I'm going to read from 8, okay? Because of this, I will weep and wail. I will go about barefoot and naked. I will howl like a jackal and moan like an owl. For her wound is incurable. It has come to Judah. It has reached the very gate of my people. So now, the enemy has reached, is coming closer, and is almost reaching the gate of Jerusalem. That is how close we are to Judgment Day, okay? And I'm not going to read the whole thing, but I'm going to read 1:16. Shave your heads in mourning, for the children in whom you delight. Make yourself as bold as a vulture, for they will go from you into exile. So basically, this whole chapter is to talk about Jerusalem, that the people in Jerusalem, they are going to be taken by the enemy, even their children, that the judgment is coming. You know, the whole time that God has showed me about the judgment, it's all about Jerusalem. It is Jerusalem. I don't even understand most of the thing, but I know it's about Jerusalem. So, yes, so it is God's people. God is definitely going to judge his own people, his own house first when the judgment day comes. So let's go to 2, men's plan and God's. Okay, and here God says why he have to punish us. First, read 2, vow to those who plan iniquity, to those who plot evil on their beds. At mornings, night they carry out, because it is in their power to do it. So this man, evil man, so it is bad enough for us to think a better thing. But this man, not that they think about it, they plan it. They plot while they're sleeping, go to bed. They plot the evil plan. And then in the morning, they carry it out, you know. So that is so evil. Our heart is so evil, you know. They do this because they say, I can do whatever I want. There's no God, and nobody's going to judge me, you know, in this world. So they live every day according to their own desire. They live without consequences. They don't think there is a God going to judge us. And now God says, you know, I'm going to show you how real I am. Okay? So, therefore the Lord says, I am planning disaster against this people, from which you cannot save yourselves. You will no longer walk proudly, for it will be a time of calamity. So those proud men, they think they're so tough. They think that they're self-built, you know, they have so much confidence in themselves. They think they can do anything, they can conquer the world. But God says there is consequences. Everything you do, everything you have done, there is consequences. And I will revenge for the people that you have treated unfairly. You have taken the house onto. You know, this man, not that they taken their home, yeah? They taken their inheritance. They taken the house, and they also taken the house of their children. They don't leave them nothing. They are robbers, you know? Those men are evil, and God will punish them. Justice will be done. And when I see this thing, I'm so angry. I tell you, there's a story I read the other day. Not long ago, so many things happening in China, injustice things, you know. So there's, you know, in China we have delivery guy who ride a motorbike. They work very hard, you know. They get paid very low wages. Okay, I think they get paid by per delivery. So the quicker they do, the more delivery they do, food they deliver, the more they get paid. Yeah. And the motorcycle they ride is actually from the company. So there's a picture of this man, this delivery guy. He was He was just standing there crying. Do you know why? Because his motorcycle has been stolen. And he's got nothing. He's got nothing. He worked whole day. He worked whole day. He make a little money already. And now his motorcycle that is stolen. That's the only thing that he rely on. He need to survive. How cruel is this world? And things like that is happening every day. In every corner. In every corner. And I'm so glad Jesus is coming. The Lion of Judah is coming. He is going to return the justice. I say justice will be done. Otherwise, this world make no sense. My husband asking me like, you know, oh, you don't need a God. He said, you don't need a God. I say, if there's no God, my life does not make sense. The whole world does not make sense. I cannot live every day just to be fine with no answer. I need to find the answer. I need to know there is justice. Justice will be done. Because my heart, I am most angry when I see injustice things happening. That is me. Because it happened to me, happened to my family, happened to many Chinese people all over the world, happened to all of us. And that makes me so angry, so angry. Okay. So the next one is the false prophet. False prophet. So the false prophet, and here, you know, many people say, oh, how we recognize false prophet. It is actually very easy over here. Over here, yeah? You please read the whole chapter, but, you know, concentrate on the next one. If a liar and a deceiver comes and says, I will prophesy for you plenty of wine and beer, he would be just the prophet for these people. So the false prophet, the one way to recognize who is a false prophet is easy. The false prophet, they prophet to please other people, not to please God. They prophet to satisfy themselves with wine, with food, for their tummy. Tummy is their God. They are not prophesy to benefit other people, but they prophesy prosperity. There are so many prosperity, prophet, teacher, you know. They make people say hallelujah, shout, dance, so happy. You feel so good after you listen to them. But they don't, those people, they do not mention about judgment or God's wrath. Because they are afraid if they do this, people won't give them money. So they are a servant of they served their tummy. They served money. And those false prophets, they will be punished. They will be punished. So let's go back, okay? So first, on this day, the time we live in now, that the army, the enemy is at the gate of Jerusalem. That is how close we are, yeah? And then God told you, justice will be done for those people who oppressed others, yeah? And then God said, the false prophet, he will punish them. Those ones who does not prophesy his word, but only say the word to please other people in order to get wine, and gold for themselves, okay? But look at the next. Deliverance promised. So this is the last message the Lord want me to tell you. Deliverance promised. So 12. I will surely gather all of you, O Jacob. I will surely bring together the remnant of Israel. I will bring them together like sheep in a pen, like a flock in its pasture. The place will throng with people. One who breaks open the way will go up before them. They will break through the gate and go out. Their king will pass through before them, the Lord at their head. And I think I have read this. I have read this chapter already. On which day? Where's my marker? Oh, sorry. Yeah, I thought I write down and marked. Yes, I studied this chapter not long time ago because God showed me after my dream. But I'm just gonna, I'm just gonna say what I feel right now. So this deliverance promise, this is about rapture day. This is about rapture. When rapture comes, you know, we will be God, the Lord. We will call his people. He is like the shepherd, the good shepherd, yeah? Calling for his name, for his sheep, for his name, yeah? He will call us. And the sheep will recognize his voice. Will come together. Will come together as a flock. He will gather the sheep in his pen. But only the one who recognizes his voice. This is very important. And how we recognize his voice? By listening to him. And who we listen to? The Lord. If you are a true born Christian, Jesus is within your heart. His spirit is inside you. So you listen to your heart. The Holy Spirit who lives in your heart, you know? And then he delivers this message to your mind and you carry out in action. And this is how we're going to hear the trumpet on that day. And fool breaks out, open the way will go up before them. One fool breaks open the way. What does that mean? The Lord has broken the chains. He has freed us from death, from sin, from corruption, from brokenness, from anything that is that has brought up down, brought the sin has damaged us. He healed us. He healed us. He repaired us. He redeemed us. This is how he breaks open the way, and he will go before us when he comes. Yeah, and they will break through the gate and go out. Go out, break through the gate. Their king will pass through before them, the Lord at their head. So I can imagine this gate is the heaven, okay? The Lord is the way, and he is the gate. And he will be our commander and our captain right in front of us, lead us into the kingdom of the heaven, okay? And he is the gate. There's no any other gate. Only Jesus Christ is the gate. So hallelujah, hallelujah. I asked the Lord the last message he want me to preach. This is it. Micah 1:10 and 2:2-13. So first, God tell you the enemy is at the gate of Jerusalem. And then he tell you he will return justice to those who oppress the poor, the widow. And then he says the false prophet will be definitely be punished. And the false prophet is here. And then hey, deliverance is promised. This is the time we live now. This is the time. And this is the final message. And I'm so happy, so happy. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you for this message. Thank you for the chapter. And thank you for the confirmation. And I ask you to go home, pray for this message. To ask the Lord. I'm sure the Lord, the Holy Spirit will give you lots of confirmation. And it is so amazing, so amazing. Okay, so that is done. Now I'm going to do my bride dance. So this song, I love this song. This song is it's a song that is in my wedding video. It was in my wedding video. I remember this song. I always loved this song, but I could not find the CD. So I actually today I played my wedding video and I recorded that song with my tablet. So when you listen, you will hear some background noise from me. So that is my wedding day. Actually, you hear it's my wedding day. Okay, so I'm gonna go in and say, pray. Okay. So I didn't rehearse dance anything, and I don't know how to dance in Japanese or Chinese. I'm just gonna dance as the Holy Spirit guide me. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. I hope that's not too bad. I just dance how the spirit guide me. Thank you. Okay, so the next prayer I want to say, not really a prayer. Okay, so. I find Micah 2:13. I wrote down here. So I wrote down Micah 2:13, the breaker anointing. God is in front of us running interference for you. He goes before you. The breaker is Lord himself. Hebrew word paratz means to break out, to break through, to increase, to advance. Going from an confined space to an enlarged space. Stand up and shout. In shatters, what's standing against you? Clap your hand. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Clap your hands with intention and purpose. You will destroy the enemy. Yay! Enemy, you better run. The thing you need to realize that when the moment you realize who you are and your power, the enemy will flee away, because then you are on the higher ground. Then he is afraid of you. He is afraid of you. Okay? Because that's the moment we are not human anymore. We are God's children. We has his Holy Spirit. So we have God's power in us. So that's the moment he's scared of us, all right? I have not been alone in my house for ages. Sometimes I forgot to do the stairs, you know. But the enemy doesn't come back. He does not come back anymore. And do you know why? Because I am not scared of him. I told him, I just have this confidence in me that I am gonna slaughter him. So he is actually, I know that he is scared of me. He is scared of me. So lift up both of your hands is a sign of surrender, and you will surrendering to the God of God, King of King. Say, you reside inside of me. You are the power inside of me. Today, I declare I will no longer think as a natural man, because a natural mind is an enmity with God. But I will think spiritually. The lion of the tribe of Judah is roaring inside of me. In the power of the name Jesus, I am becoming as a lion. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't know when I wrote this, but this is great. Thank you so much, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, I find this. Okay, this is the last thing I'm gonna say. Okay. Out of the desire of love, God created me. Out he spoke the word of truth. In a blink of an eye, I was given birth. So by the word of the truth, I shall live, for lie is no longer affecting me. Because I know who I am, where I come from, where am I going, and who my creator is. So by the word of truth that created, by the same word of truth, I shall be saved and receive the eternal perfect gift given by my Lord Jesus Christ. Coming down from the Father of heavenly lights, I shall receive eternal life, peace, and joy. Amen. And some small notes I wrote down.